Hi, my name is Marissa, and this is another episode of Slabtown Slubs. If you're a returning viewer, welcome back. And if you are a new viewer, welcome to the podcast. So I'm coming at you from Portland, Oregon, where I live with my husband and our three little boys and our dog and cat. It's been a long time since I recorded. I put up my Christmas haul video partway through January with like no edits or anything, so I hope it came out okay. Don't even know if I rewatched it or anything, but I was just kind of done. So anyway, let me get my handy dandy phone out where I put in some notes for this episode. There it is. I'm trying something new this week. I was watching a Patty Mac Knits podcast last week or two, and she did a tutorial on how to use QuickTime to record a video. So I'm trying that out because last time I recorded on my computer, I used the Photo Booth app and it kind of squished the video down so it didn't look. I was like kind of stretched this way and squished this way, or maybe it was just kind of weird. So I never put it up and I just re-recorded it on my phone, and the audio keeps going out of sync on my phone. So I'm trying this way to see if that helps at all. So, yeah, I guess we'll just get right into it and start with finished objects, which I only have four of since last time I talked to you guys. So the first thing that I finished was my first FO of this year, and it is the First Night Hat. I wonder if this First Night Hat by Knitting School Dropout. And I forgot her real name, but this is a newish pattern by her, and I've kind of been following Melissa is her name, Melissa Labar. I've been following her since back in the day when I started knitting and was looking at blogs all the time and stuff. So it has a really cool diamond pattern. That's a pretty good representation of it. Just made from, you know, knits and purls, and it knit up, I think, in one night. It was really quick. It's a DK, I think it's DK. DK or worsted, I forgot, but it's a cute little hat, and hers has a pom-pom on it, but I tried to make a pom-pom, and I totally failed for this hat, so I think I'm just gonna skip it. Yeah, it was really quick and fun, and it was just like a nice kind of palette cleanser at the beginning of the year because I still have a bunch of stuff on the needles from last year that I've maybe lost interest in right now, and I'm hoping to get back to that stuff at some point. So yeah, that was a cool hat to just get done in one day. Maybe a day and a half of knitting time, I don't know. But it was really nice to just get something off the needles because I was in the middle of so many projects. So that was cool. So yeah, Knitting School Dropout, Melissa Labar, check out her patterns. She's been around forever and she's awesome. So yeah, next thing was my, this is not blocked yet. My Glacier Park cowl. It came out pretty amazing and I'm very pleased with it. Even though, you know, my tension is off, and I think I switched like exactly halfway through right around here which yarn I was holding in the front. So the tension kind of got flipped around and whatever, it's fine. So I got my ends all weaved in. It's a little taller than it's supposed to be, and honestly, I don't really cowl, so, fluff everything back up. I mean, I guess it looks okay. But I just, wanted to do, sorry, I got a little, I wanted to do a color work project, and this was fairly small, and my friend Jamie had just done it as her first color work, and she loved it, and I loved hers, and I love this pattern. Oh, I forgot, on I dyed this yarn. This is just some DK, or some worsted yarn that it's kind of a little finer than normal worsted, but I dyed this, I showed it to you guys, I think over the summer. It was one of the first few skeins that I dyed up. Anyway, back to this. this is, the gray is Tosh Merino Light in Composition Book Gray. And this is the third and final project that I have been able to squeeze out of that one ball of yarn. And the rest is going to go into my crochet granny stripe blanket. And the light color is called Sweet Dream or Sweet Dreams by Fiber Fools. And this is their sparkle sock. And it doesn't really show up even in real life, but perhaps the camera could pick it up. I don't really know. But yeah, this was really cool. The only kind of tedious part was this long stretch of the repeat. But other than that, all the little different things up in here kind of made it really fun. And then you just kind of get to finish off with some nice ribbing just to get it done. You know what I mean? So yeah, it was a really cool pattern and I recommend it. And, if you're doing okay. Hi. So I ran out of space on my computer. So we're back on the phone. So actually, I think the quality is a little bit better here. Sorry. Get a little sip of water. And you know, whatever, it's back to the old normal way that we do it. And that was a fun experiment, and I'm going to use the clip because I'm not going to do all that over again. I was showing you the cowl, and it is not blocked. So I think maybe when it gets blocked, what I was saying, how the switching around of the yarn in the front and the back, maybe it'll even out a little bit. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, I think that's all I have to say about that. So next thing is my speckled space socks. I finished these last week on, I think, Tuesday night. Yeah, this was a pretty fun knit, and I enjoyed it. And the only thing I didn't like is that on the leg repeats, you have to kind of shuffle around the stitches. And if you remember, I was doing these two at a time, and so that got a little bit hairy. Got a little complicated. Not too bad. I mean, I figured it out for sure in the end, but each chart repeat requires you to switch the stitches, the first stitch, kind of back and forth, I think 3 times total. Yeah. So, but, yeah, this is in my hand-dyed yarn, Peppermint Bark colorway, Do we do focusing? I don't think we do, but we can get the color and kind of a fun close-up of
the striping and the stitch pattern. So that was super fun to do, and it was fun working with my own yarn. So yeah, I don't think I have a lot of finished things that I have made with my own yarn that I've dyed myself. So yeah, 2 in 1 month. And then I will switch. I only have one set of blockers that fits my size sock. I have another set of blockers in the basement that I purchased, and they're too big. So, or no, too small. I need the medium ones for my tootsies here. So, just, I want to show you how weird and skinny my socks look. They're just, they look all long, like I've got these giant feet, but I put them on the blocker and they look normal, so. Let me get the other one on so you can see the pair, because they're pretty cute if I do say so myself. So I am doing the Cat Sandwich Fibers Sock Along. And so she's making a club colorway sock yarn each month, and you knit a sock out of each color each month, and I think at the end of each month there's prizes, and then whoever does all 12 colors is eligible for like a bigger prize at the end of the year. And this is the first colorway, called Mr. and Mrs. B. And it is inspired by her wedding colors. And yeah, it's like this really pretty kind of maroon with black and purple speckles in the light peachy kind of white color. And then I did contrast heels, toes, and cuffs in a yarn by Julie Asselin. And the base is called Nomad, and the color is called Plaid. The red, the heels, toes, and cuffs is called Plaid. And the cat sandwich yarn is in her trusty sock base. And I did my first afterthought heels. Ha ha! They look great, and I think I love them. They're super comfortable. They make this portion of the sock tighter, which I like. I wish I could make my socks even more tight. I think I might try going down to 48 stitches on all my vanilla socks. These ones are tight, but it's because of the patterning. And these have 56 stitches, and these also have 56 stitches, but these are a little more loosey-goosey than these ones are. And I also, I think I did the bind-off wrong on here because it doesn't stretch quite as much as I'd like. So I did it a little differently on this one. And it's a little more stretchy. So I'm still working out my formula. I thought I liked 56 stitches, but I might go down to 48. I don't know. We'll see. I can just leave those on. And that's it. That's what I finished. Two pairs of socks, a cowl, and a hat. It's like small knitting central over here. And I'm in the middle of about 5 million medium to big size projects. So, I'm going to pause because I don't want my clips to start getting wonky, and then I'm going to go grab something that I forgot. I'll be right back. Hi. I'm back. Changed my angle just a little bit. I think it was getting kind of crazy. Oh, and I forgot to tell you what I'm wearing. This is my Buccaneer shawl, pattern by Litties Knits or Justina. Last name? I don't know her last name. First name is Justina. And this is made out of not fiber and hue. I forgot. I'll put it on the screen. I forgot. I'm sorry, Die Artist. You did. This is the Rainbow Graffiti and Grayscale. I know the names of the yarn. But isn't this cool? I love this thing. I love it. Okay. Enough of that. Works in progress. Okay, so first I'll just show you this. I'll show you this tragic thing that happened. Can you even? I left the cap off of my pen. And it leaked all over my bag. Luckily, it did not leak all over my yarn. This is my doodler. Stephen West pattern. And I'm doing the Christy Glass Knits Doodler Cowl, where you only work on it on Sundays. I'm using House of Alamode in Glitter Gaudy, Glitter Cafe, and the border is going to be in Glitter Cloud. Aren't these just amazing? They're gorgeous. I got these three in just a random update. I think it was the first one I was able to kind of catch before it came down. And decided to put them together in this project. And then I have my little French Toasty Progress Keeper from the Gnome Knitter. But this is really fun to work on, and it's nice to not have any pressure. It's nice to just pull it out on Sunday, work on it for a little while, and then put it away. You see all my ends hanging out. And it's a beautiful pattern. I mean, you've probably seen it. And it's really fun, and it's, you know, it's fairly easy. It's not, like, completely mindless, but it's, you know, you don't have to sit there and be like, clutching the needles and hoping that no children climb on you and make stitches fall off. That's my life. So yeah, it's my first Stephen West pattern, my first, House of Alamode project, and I'm loving it. It's, I think it's the House fingering base. Let me see here. Yeah. 2-ply. Does this show up? It's really blurry. What if I go away? Nope. Sorry. Okay, yeah, so that's that project, and I'm loving it, and it'll be done sometime, hopefully this year. I was kind of thinking about cheating and just trying to finish it up real quick before House of Alamode and Republic of Wool are hosting a pop-up shop during the Rose City Yarn Crawl. Beginning of next month, and I thought it would be cool to have a House of Alamode thing, wearing a thing when I go to see them and buy all the yarn, but I don't know if I can get it done, so we'll see. I might just leave it. I also have another thing that I cast on that maybe I could finish that instead. It's also on my Make 9. If you go on my Instagram at SlabTownSlubs, you can check out my Make 9 post from January. Alright, and I literally have 1 million things. I don't literally have 1 million things on my needles. But it's a lot, so strap in, because I have actually touched all of these since the last time I did a podcast. Alright, So this is my other House of Alamode thing, and it lives in this beautiful Earl Grey Fiber Company bag, and check out that gold in the cork bottom. And this is like, you can squish it and nothing happens to it. This is not brittle cork like you're used to. It's wonderful and I love it. And you should go to Earl Grey Fiber Company and buy one of her awesome project bags and some yarn. Anyway, so I started working on my Be Mine cardigan by Vera Valimaki. And I just have the collar. I'm working on increasing, I think. Yeah, it's been like a week since I worked on this, but check out that yarn. This is Glitter Storm from House of Alamode. It kind of reminds me a little bit of Amy's sweater from La Bien Amie. La Bien Amie. She's American, okay? I didn't know that. I think she's American. All I've seen is expat. Maybe she's Canadian. I don't know. She's not from France, I don't think. Pretty sure. So I don't know if we're saying it Ami or if it's Amy, because I know of people who pronounce it either way and they spell it the same way. People say La Bien Amie. But maybe she's just Amy. I don't know. But anyway, it kind of looks like Ami's sweater, but with more rainbow, like extra rainbow, which is my style, as you can see. I still do play guitar, but I started when I was 13-ish, maybe 14, 13 or 14, and my first strap that I bought for myself was a sweet rainbow guitar strap. So I've always been into rainbows. Oh, even when I was like a tiny kid, I had this awesome picture on my wall of these two kids sliding down a rainbow into a pot of gold. And like, I wish I could find it again. I know it didn't make it with us when we moved when I was like 8, I think. I don't think you guys care about this story. Anyway, yeah, my love for rainbows is long and strong. And I forgot to mention my little fortune cookie progress keeper, also from the Gnome Knitter. Isn't it cute? So yeah, maybe I could finish this in time for the pop-up. That would be pretty sweet, because this color is amazing. And I don't really care if it pulls, because, I mean, hello, awesomeness. I don't care. I really don't. Pull away, rainbows. I love you. Okay. So that's that one. Crinkle, crinkle. Oh! You know what? Maybe I'll get, like, the smaller stuff out of the way first. The smaller, or least progress. I also cast on, this week, a, Sandy cardigan by Poison Girls. It's like hardly any progress. Hardly any. But, oh, tiny little back of a sweater. Tiny little quilting stitch diamonds. Yes. You can see that. It's amazing. My little stitch diamonds. It's just, I got like what, 1.5 inches, 2 inches on here. And I'm using Knit Picks Gloss DK. And potentially, if I could finish this in time, which I don't think I can, put it into the Stranded Dye Works commercial yarn cow. That'd be cool. Yeah. Sandy cardigan. That'll be really cute. I'm looking forward to adding that to my wardrobe. And that is in this really cute Project bag by Stitch Life Bags. Look at that fabric. It's Peter Pan and Wendy and a baby. I don't know what the baby's name is. Isn't that cute? And it's an awesome bag. There's no pockets, but that's fine. Not all bags have to have pockets. Got a little ribbon strap. Complimentary color. And double drawstrings, which I love, which I wish this one had. It only has one drawstring on one side and a handle on the other side. So when I have to like tie this one in a half bow knot thing so my babies don't get in there. This one I can just whoop, do a little double knot, boom. No babies allowed. Okay. And let's see here. What is, I don't even know what's in here. I think it's a, oh, it's my spike. It's my spike. Ta-da! This is a Fabric Fancies bag. Very cute. I have not shown this. I cast this on after I posted my last video. And that's the back. Here it is. I did show this on my Instagram, on my little try-on. I'm going to start a new clip. Starting a new clip. Yeah, so this is my Zweig. I did my lace. I did my color work. It came out perfect. I'm probably, how many inches is that? Like 5 or 6 maybe inches through the body with the little beautiful X cables. And yeah, this has been a really fun and really awesome knit. I put it down for a little bit, just the little cables, they get a little tedious. So I do maybe like one full repeat of the chart and then set it down for a little bit and then do another repeat. There's about 16 rows per repeat, I think. So, but it's coming along. I mean, that's pretty good. Be right back again. Okay, so I have to tell you about this problem I had. There's some short row shaping on the back of the neck to, you know, to make it sit higher than the front because that's more comfortable for lots of people. And while I was doing that, I missed that you're supposed to go past the marker, a marker in the pattern. So I stopped at the marker and came back. And so my short rows were only half the size, half of the, you know, stitch count that they were supposed to be. And so I had like this hump on half of the back and then the rest was kind of like flat. And I didn't realize I had done this. I thought it was a little bit weird, but I was like, I'm going to trust the pattern. It's fine. And I got all the way through the lace, all the way through the last color work, and split the sleeves. And that's when I realized the back of the sweater was wonky. And I was so upset, and I was like, I can't do it all over again. I mean, I can, but I was just, you can imagine, I'm sure. But I went on to the Ravelry group for Boyland Knitworks, and they have a help thread for each pattern because, you know, they're all pretty involved. And so I went to the help thread for the Zweig, and some angel had just done that to her sweater and told me what she had done, and I was able to fix it without having to redo all the color work and lace. So now you can't even tell what happened, and it's amazing. It's just amazing. So I basically picked up stitches all the way around just above the color work, and then knit the short rows in reverse order and re-knit a neck band, and yeah, it came out. So yay, I didn't have to do everything over again, and the fix was, you know, it was pretty straightforward and simple, and it was just doing some short rows and knit, 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 and rib, 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 and done and done. Repeat, repeat. So, fix my shirt. It's kind of bunching a little bit funny. There we go. I don't know. Anyway, really fun knit. You should totally do it. I only cast this on because of the, what's she called, bat wings and bunny ears on Instagram. I watched her podcast where she had finished hers, and she said, it's easy, just do it on there. And I was like, it doesn't look easy, but it actually, you know, wasn't that hard. It wasn't that bad. So, and this is my first, like, good lace that I've done. I mean, does this count as lace? If this counts as lace, then this is probably, but this is like a little more involved. So it went really well, and I'm just so happy. I love the colors, by the way. I didn't mention the colors. The purple is by Beehive Yarns, and it's called Dear Prudence, and it's on her 2-ply, I think it's 2-ply, kind of twist. I don't know what the base, Audrey? And then the yellow is Junk Yarn in the color Drew, and I showed you that in my Christmas haul, and it's Sparkle. And again, it's kind of a shimmer more than a sparkle. But I think it'll be fun when I wear it. And yeah, I'm really happy with how they're kind of going together, and I can't wait to finish and wear it, because it's going to be comfortable, A, and beautiful. I mean, come on. Come on. I think my only complaint, and it's not even a big deal, is that I think they used, like, maybe the same pink color, because the color work blends in some places between the purple and the yellow colors. But, like, you can see it, so it's not that big of a deal. It's just, oh, my little nacho plate, also from the Gnome Knitter. Whenever she doesn't update, I can't help myself. I can't. I mean, it's knitting stuff, but it's only, you know, it's, like, way less expensive than buying a bunch of yarn, and it's fun, and it makes me happy, so. Cool. So we've done these. Oh, and then my Comfort Fade Cardi. I have a sleeve. I don't think I had a sleeve. I don't know. I didn't. So I finished the body, and I have a sleeve, and I'm working on the second sleeve. We got piano practice going on in the background, in case you're wondering what in the heck that is. I have it flipped inside out, because I'm knitting the sleeves instead of purling them, because it's a reverse stockinette. Yep, there it is. So we're calling this my CMYK Comfort Fade Cardi, like the printer colors. So you get the full effect there, and then like the mini fade on the sleeve. So on this other sleeve, I'm not going to flip it. I'm still on the pink, but I think I'm two rounds away from starting the green fade in. Like that. So, yeah. I was going to, like, buckle down and just do the sleeve last night, and then I got distracted by a different project that I'm about to show you. So, anyway, it's coming along, and it's pretty sure I can get it done before the end of this cowl. And be eligible to win that La Bien Ami exclusive yellow fringe field bag. And this is in my gigantic and beautiful That Crafty Little Fox bag. This is the Like a Boss size, and I've got the sweater, and I think three partial skeins in here, plus the pattern, plus a pen, plus a tape measure, so, and it still, if I give it a little shove, still closes. And this has a wax canvas bottom and a leather strappy. Really well-made bag. Try to catch an update if you can, because her bags are awesome. So then I'll show you my socks that I'm working on, and then one more after that. So, one sec. Okay, so I'm making some socks for my middle kiddo. And they are housed in this cute modular project bag, sock bag with sloth fabric and super fun, bright, coordinating lime green fabric. And here they are. Little tiny ribbed socks for my little boy. He is 6 years old. And I'm using the Susan B. Anderson ribbed socks for kids pattern. I'm using a 2mm needle, which is kind of my go-to for socks. She suggests a size 2 US, and these are a size 0. So I know I like my socks nice and tight. So, and I think he does too. I think he's a mama's little boy. And this yarn is Cascade Heritage Prints in number 23, also called Autumn. And I'll show you what that looks like in the ball. I made two little balls of yarn because on my speckled space socks, I tried to just knit from the inside and outside of the ball, and I hated it, so I'd rather take the time to split the ball in half and weigh it into two little 50 gram balls and knit that way, because it's a lot easier to keep the yarn in order for me that way. Yeah, so easy peasy so far. Yeah, he likes the yarn. It is Ivan approved. His name is Ivan, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that. Yeah. And then I am making another pair of socks for me. Also in a very cute modular bag in a Charlie Harper print with some cardinals. Okay, socks. These are some socks by Luna Pearl Yarn, or no, they're by me, but the yarn is by Luna Pearl Yarn. And she just dyes the best self-striping colorways. And this one is called Atomic Mermaid. I'm doing a toe up with Judy's Magic Cast On, 56 stitches. On a size 0 needle, not size 0, yeah, size 0, 2mm needle, and then I have my little Thumbprint Cookie Progress Keeper. And I've got a full repeat down, working on getting into my second stripe of a repeat here. So these are going to be totally awesome, and people that I run into on the street are going to think I'm insane, but I mean, come on. I had to do it. I showed in a different episode the Polaris that I purchased from her. I think I bought them at separate times. I think I got the Polaris first, and then I came back for this one, but I haven't cast on the Polaris yet. So yeah, and this is what it looks like in the ball. Totally awesome and crazy. Oh, and I gotta mention, in the bag, this little bag has pockets with the outer fabric. Did the sloth one also have that? I think it does. She probably does them all in a similar fashion. But her bags are really cute and awesome and cool. Yeah, so the sloth has also some inner pockets in the sloth fabric. So, yeah. There's my sockies. Okay. Last work in progress is some, I'm kind of blowing through this. I started this probably almost 2 weeks ago. Surprise Party Shawl by Curious Handmade, aka Helen Stewart. My color choices, they could have been more well thought out, but this was kind of a... I saw a kit from Hue Loco. It was a new kit, and it was actually like colors that I liked, because the first two ones, they're not really my palette. But she made one that was a little bit more so, but it was kind of a lot more than I wanted to spend. So I stashed dove, and I found some minis that were cool and made this amazing shawl. So the main color is Cloudborn Black Walnut in their single base, and the minis are the red, the rainbow, the blue, and the gray are color redefined, and she has a shop on Etsy, and then the pink is Blissful Knits, and she also has an Etsy shop, and she's from Oregon. So I was like, oh god, because the speckling and the kind of the repeating, it just, you know, it's not perfect. It's not. Let's face it. But it looks cool. I mean, come on, man. I'm gonna be styling walking around with this at after school pickup. My awesome surprise party shawl. So I am, according to the pattern, let's see if I can... She gives you percentages. So, I'm currently at... I just finished the row that puts me at 80% done. So, I could have this finished probably in a couple days. Which would be amazing, because I'm really excited about it. It's just so fun. Look at this pattern. It's a super fun pattern. If you're on the fence, do it. Just do it. A lot of stitches, but you know, who cares? It's fine. We get through it. And the Cloudborn, you guys should really try. It's made by, it's on Craftsy, the Craftsy website. And it's just so soft and squishy, and I love it, and I can't wait to just snuggle up in it. Do you like my weird faces? I hope you do. Because I can't do anything about it. It's my face, okay? And that's also in another modular bag, and that has some Charlie Harper fabric also. I don't know what these birds are, though. So, and it has some same inside pocket is the outside fabric, and you know, a solid red matches my lipstick almost. Okay, so I'll put this away. And that's my final work in progress. Let me count. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 that I've been working on, and I have more than that are hibernating, so. But, I don't know. I have lofty goals, I guess. That's fine. Maybe a little sip of water. Because boy oh boy, am I talking a lot, and I don't normally talk that much, so whatever. We'll move on to projects coming up, / acquisitions, and then we'll be done. Because I think we've done a little bit of random chit-chat in between stuff, so yeah. Sorry for the non-structured whatever. So eloquent I am. Alright, so one of the next things I want to cast on is the little red hooded cardigan by Vera Valimaki from my Color Wheel Knits book that I showed you. And I dyed some yarn for it, and it's coming up a little more pink than it is in real life. Maybe if I... Nope. It's not pink. It is red. It's a blue-red. Like a... It's not pink at all. On my screen, it looks very, very pink. If I go like that. I don't know. But I dyed up 5 skeins for that pattern, and I love it, and it matches my face. My lipstick. Okay, sorry. Going nuts here. And I also dyed up a skein for my friend Pilar, but I already sent it away just yesterday, in fact. I was kind of holding on to it because I thought I was going to do a podcast last week, but I didn't. It's been weird and busy and hard to find, you know, an hour or so to sit down with you guys and do this stuff. So I'm doing my best. So I'll carry on. I'll put a picture here of my yarn that I made for Pilar. And then finally, I had a bunch of red left in the pot from these. So I stuck in... Actually, why don't I unwind one of these for you just to kind of show it off a little bit. It's double dipped in a red and a cherry. So it has a really fun kind of variegation to it. And then, okay, so back to this one. I'm calling this one Conversation Hearts because it reminds me of the color from Conversation Hearts. And look at those speckles, you guys. I'm doing all right in the speckle department. I think I've got it figured out. And then half of it is red. So it's not a sock yarn, so I can't make socks out of it. It's just a single 100% superwash merino base. So, I think I'm gonna make some fingerless mitts out of this. That'll be fun, right? So, yeah. That's my fun experiment with leftover dye plus some speckles. So that'll be pretty cool to see, what happens when I knit it up. Alright, and then I got another That Crafty Fox, Crafty Little Fox bag with red pandas, Which is also a little bit guitar related because on my guitar case I have a big picture of a red panda that my brother laminated for me. He laminated it for me when he worked at Kinko's. And so red pandas are kind of like one of my favorite animals. And so, yeah, and it has this pretty blue patterned fabric on the inside and some pockets and a little button that I put on there that says not my president, and that's from what is her name, Bethy something. I'll write it on the screen. Bethy something. She has an Etsy shop and she has an Instagram. Yeah, and again, a wax canvas bottom in purple and a leather strappy and drawstrings. So this fit six skeins of yarn just now. That's where I was holding on to my yarn that I had dyed. And that brings me to this yarn that I dyed. I got some new colors in December and I wanted to try them out. So this is the cherry all by itself. Maybe if I put the red. Nope. It all looks the same. So yeah, it has some cherry, it has some aqua, and I put a little bit of brown speckle, like you can just barely see it right there. So this will be, I think I'm going to make like a one skein shawl out of this. I have the knit vent patterns from Curious Handmade. And I'm having so much fun with a surprise party shawl. Might as well throw another one on the needles later. And you guys, like, only one thing that I'm knitting on right now is from my Make Night. And all this stuff, not all of it, but a lot of it I cast on after the new year. So, I'm crazy. But that's okay. That's why you like me. That's what I tell my husband. Okay. Next up is some more junk yarn. This is her, I think this was the December Club color, and it's also a Stellina base. I think she calls it Starlet, and it is Rose Tico. Did you guys see Star Wars? You know Rose Tico? Awesome! So this is going to be, I want to do like a really special sock pattern. I just gotta find the right one. But this is some really pretty yarn. It has like a rosy red, and the white has green flecks in it, and then it has a kind of persimmon orange that's not showing up. Maybe on the sides it's a little bit better. But yeah, I split this one out already because this is gonna be my next socks when I'm done with my stripies or my little kid socks. Yeah. And another purchase I made was a 5-color fade kit from House of Ala Mode. And I am gonna do my, sorry for the smacking. I know I hate that noise. I hate that noise. It's by, it's a Stephen West pattern. And it is the Dotted Ray Speckle Fade. Got it. That didn't work at all. Okay. Alright. You guys know I have trouble holding yarns. Okay. If you watch some of my older episodes, it's pretty ridiculous. It's especially bad when they are already caked up. Okay. So, there we go. That'll be amazing. I was thinking I would start with the yellow and fade out to the blues, but I think I might start with the blue so that there's like a ton of yellow on the outer rim. That would be pretty sweet. So let me tell you the colors. This beautiful yellow is called Daffodil. Seasonally appropriate. We've got some daffodils blooming in the neighborhood right now. And then this one is called Ode to Anthro, which I've been lusting over. So serious. For a few months now. And finally, it was in an update, and it was only in the kit, so that's kind of why I bought the whole thing, but also, it's a beautiful kit, so. Yeah. And this one is called Forest Nymph. My baby's name is Forest, but he's not a nymph, he's a human. And this one is called Calypso. So it's got some similar colors, but got some white and a little bit more of a speckle. And then this one, what's the difference here? These are pretty close. This is called Orbit. So it's pretty close to the Forest Nymph, actually, but that's okay. I can dig it, you know? Anyway, that was a pretty big purchase. But, you know, I love, love, love her speckling. Heather is a speckle genius, and her peeps that work there are probably just as genius because she must have taught them what to do. And I got two more things, and then we're done. Okay. Last yarn thing is this beautiful club color from Down Sheepy Lane, and it came with this cute snowflake little stitch marker and also a contrast mini. Look at this. It's so pretty. And it's called Do the Magic, which it looks like magic, quite frankly. It's really pretty, and I like, it's a sock yarn, and it's a sock club, and it's a sock set, but I think I want to make a neckwear, maybe another shawl, a mini shawl. Will it match this? Are these too contrasty? Probably. They both have kind of a blue-green. But, yeah, I think they're, maybe I could stripe them or something. I don't know. But, yeah, so that's all I got for yarn. And then yesterday, I received this Japanese knitting stitch Bible. You guys need to get this. I just got it on Amazon. I think they were out of stock for a while, and finally it came back in stock. And holy moly, you guys. Can you see that? Look at that. Look at this. I mean, I'm pretty sure that one of these is the same as the whatchamacallit, White Horse. Is that not White Horse by Boyland Knitworks? It looks like it. But I'm gonna knit that sweater, by the way. Totally gonna knit that sweater. I have some yarn in a cart to make that sweater because holy moly, beautiful. And the reverse stockinette paired with that lace is like amazing. So yeah, her patterns are just awesome. And I'm gonna make the Kodakus shawl, a little triangle. See, I'm making a triangle, and I'm gonna make the Nelchina, I think that's how you say it, at some point. I think it's beyond my level right now, but I am going to make that sweater because wow. If you haven't seen it, go look it up. It's amazing, 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 amazing. And that, seriously, you guys, why did I even say that? That doesn't make any sense. You guys, I'm done. I'm done with the podcast. Take a little sip. And that's everything. I hope it wasn't too long. We'll see. Hopefully I'll have this up by Saturday. It is now Thursday, so I can spend tomorrow and this evening editing and then start uploading, which takes forever, by the way. I don't know if you guys knew that. It's a long video, you know. Anyway, have a happy. Bye.